What's up, people? Today I would like to show you newest model of Neumann Studio Monitors, model KH150. So let me remind you about Neumann. This is legendary German developer and manufacturer of audio equipment for studios with huge experience and traditions. The heart of any studio person will tremble at the mention of this name. Microphones and monitors, there's a legend. Although, at the first glance, the modern line of studio monitors was unfinished. KH80, then KH120, and then three-way KH310. With the advent of the KH150 model, the lineup was filled. Moreover, KH150 takes us to the network jungle. Enjoy! The KH150 AES67 two-way near-field studio monitor is built according to the B-amping design under DSP control with plaque resolution and super flat frequency response. Of the main features noted on the site, linear frequency and phase response, DSP engine for improved performance and automatic room alignment, deep low and down to 39 Hz and high SPL capability. It is almost like the three-way model KH310 and at the same time a high level of sound pressure. And all this with incredible linearity and low distortion, analog and digital connectivity. There are a lot of versions here on the website. You may think that there are a lot of different models, but it isn't. These versions differ in the presence or absence of network functions, like audio over internet protocol, compatible with AES67 compatible protocols such like Ravenna and Dante, which allow all sorts of multi-channel configurations to be made from these monitors. Then different colors of cases. Well, different equipment with network cables of different countries. I know, you can read yourself, and I will not ramble on the content on the site. However, pay attention, please, to the linearity on the range of 100 Hz to 10 kHz. This is less than 1 dB, and delay is less than 2.6 milliseconds. Cool, isn't it? In general, this website is beautiful, and the detailing on the parameters is fantastic. You can find anything. I also note max SPL calculator in half space at 3% of distortion at 1 meter is about 190 dB SPL. Switching power supply. Crossover frequency 1007 Hz, 24 dB per octave. Pretty low, but pretty strong. Infrasonic filter about 38 Hz and 12 dB per octave. PWM amplifiers on their own design for 145W woofer and 100W for tweeter. Speaker size for woofer is 6.5 inches and for tweeter is 1 inch. Internal net volume 12.6 liters. Product weight is about 8 kg. What follows is a detailed set of diagrams describing how this marvel of technology works. By the way, this collection of measurements was made at my office in Clippy Lab on a near-field scanner and gives comprehensive information about the tested speaker. I'm going to talk about this and show the measurements process, but remembering the reaction of the video about the anechoic chamber, I'm postponing this process for later. Well, here's the horizontal radiation pattern. Here along the vertical, you can see the consequences of the work of the elliptical waveguide, which forms the limitation of the sound flow along the vertical in order to avoid parasitic reflections from the table on the operator's console. Here is the frequency response itself with the promised deviation like plus minus 0.8 dB in the area of main responsibility, to easy say, like a stick. Next is the group delay plot, which is negligible for such a compact solution. And here is the result of frequency correction, which is often asked about. Here you can see what is regulated and where. Let me remind you what a good regulator is a disabled regulator. What means why? Because otherwise all these charts fly away, you know where to. harmonic distortion factor for 80 dB, here for 85 dB, here for 90 dB, here is 95 dB. Well, the graph of the maximum sound pressure, and well, phase drift in the operating frequency range, also indicated for this format. Now let's look at monitor leaf. Woofer. Isn't there too much bass? Is asked here on the side. Indeed, the low-end linearity of this 6.5-ported woofer is amazing. The developer wrote to me what the company spent a lot of effort, time and money on developing the sweet couple, targeting high linear exclusion and very low distortion. An internal DSP equalizes each KH150 with very tight tolerances, plus minus 0.8 dB from 100 Hz to 10 kHz. And I could say I was convinced of this during listening. However, I will also give you this opportunity. Of course, it's better to do it yourself, but anyway, this resonator is an engineering marvel, and it's protected by a decorative grille. Inside the monitor is made in full compliance with the requirements of the industry. Neat, clean, reliable and tasteful. Because Neumann. Tweeter. Tweeter loaded to mathematically modeled dispersion MMD waveguide. Guarantees a wide sweet spot and minimize stable reflections. In addition, the built-in DSP allow for room calibration using automatic branding. MA1, sold separately, adjusts this model with its DSP to the cheruster of your room in the listening position. This simple action allows you to get a sound field in your studio that is much smoother than without correction. By the way, look at the result of correction MA1. Strongly does make sense. Please pay attention to the ports. The triangular shape is very close to me. In my masterpiece, the Lange model, which I showed in one of the videos, I used such a port, a convenient, effective and beautiful thing. There are two ports with a large total area, high efficiency and the complete absence of turbulent noise. Neumann logo. It displays the mode and status of the monitor, although a whole section in the manual is devoted to this topic. Shortly to say, in normal operation, Neumann logo is white, identification mode, Neumann logo rose, limit clipper errors, protection, boot mute, shutdown mute, Neumann logo is red. Logo brightness controlled via MA1 software. The front panel is made from composite polycarbonate. The body case made from MDF. The back side is metal and contain controls and switching. Let's see the top of control panel. Adapting loudspeakers to the environment using the switches on the backplate. Bass compensation is possible with value 0, minus 2, minus 4, minus 6 dB. Conventionally, the mid frequency register is corrected within 0, minus 2, minus 4, minus 6 dB. And high frequency correction plus 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2 dB is possible. The small limits of regularization remind us these are not tone control, but precision professional tool. The next block of regulators is a discrete setting of the output signal level. Position 94, 100, 108, 14 dB. And the smooth input level control gain from 0 to minus 15 dB. The next control block contains the selection of the signal source. This is analog with XLR connector, SPDIF, left-right, which connects the appropriate RCA sockets and network interface, AES67, audio network stream, RG45 sockets, primary and secondary. Next is ground lift, which kicks first pin of the XLR to avoid the parasite loop. And the last switch control, which switches between the network and local state of the monitor. The middle of the monitor, power switch, 6 mm mounts hole, a pair. model name KH150AES67, digital input and output. Below are two network ports, secondary and primary. And in the lower part, there is a power cable connector and an XLR analog input connector. Okay, now we can listen to a test recording of the voice of these monitors on my old set of tracks. I really hope you can get an idea of how this little guy handles music over a wide range of frequency at pretty big volume levels while doing so.